Let us look at the definition of banking as given in the Banking Companies Regulation Act. It is a very wonderful definition. Wonderful because, you know, this was incorporated in 1949. And today we are in post 2000 era. And even today, this definition is valid. We'll see the various ingredients of the definition and also the definition itself, which is a very interesting piece of legislation. Section 5B of the Banking Regulation Act defines banking as accepting for the purpose of lending or investment of deposits of money from the public, repayable on demand or otherwise, and withdrawable by check, draft, and order or otherwise. It at first appears to be a lot of mumbo jumbo, but let us parse this definition into its various ingredients so that we can appreciate the beauty of this definition. First is, what is banking? Accepting of deposits. Let me note it down one after the other. Accepting of deposits from public. Very important point. Underline this. A banker's job begins by accepting deposits. Accepting from whom? Uncle, aunt, brother, son-in-law, mother-in-law? No. Accept deposits from public. Then, what is the purpose of such acceptance? Rend. Second, for investment or lending. For lending or investment. This is the second aspect of the definition. Here, first is, a banking is accepting of deposits from the public. Then second is, what is the purpose of such accepting the deposit? To lock it up? No, it is for lending and or investment. Then third is repayable on demand. Demand or otherwise. The money a banker accepts is repayable on demand. This is the beauty of it. Only a banker can accept money repayable on demand. Repayable on demand or otherwise. Then the fourth aspect of this definition is, it is withdrawable by check, draft or otherwise. Draft or otherwise. Now, what are the four elements of this beautiful definition? First is, banking is accepting of deposits from the public. The purpose of accepting the deposit is lending or investment. And the deposit is repayable. Well, let us not forget, a banker accepts the deposit, he cannot take it and go home and enjoy the fruits of the deposits himself or for his family. He has to repay it. It is repayable again on demand, or sometimes you accept fixed deposit as well as demand deposits. So it is repayable on demand or otherwise. And then this is the final point, withdrawable by check. Only a banker can issue a checkbook. A non-banking finance company cannot issue a checkbook because they cannot accept demand deposits. So the four characteristics of this definition is that, accepting of deposits from the public for lending or investment. You take the deposit and then you keep it with you. You cannot. You have to lend it. Then only, because you have to pay interest to your depositor. How will you pay interest to the depositor? You have to lend the money or invest the money for lending or investment. And third aspect is, it is the money, please remember, it is a warning to the banker that the money you take as deposit is repayable on demand. Whenever the depositor comes and asks for the money, you should give it. Whenever the depositor issues a check, you should honor it. You have the bounden responsibility and duty to honor the check. It is repayable on demand. And then a banker alone can issue a checkbook. No NBFC can do it. A banker alone can issue. The money that is deposited is withdrawable by check draft or otherwise. Now if you look carefully in this definition, there are two otherwises. First, there is one first otherwise, and there is a second otherwise. What does the first otherwise talk about? It is repayable on demand or otherwise. The money that a banker takes from a depositor, has to be repayable on demand. If it is a current account or a savings bank account, whenever the customer comes and asks for it, the banker should repay it. Suppose it is a fixed deposit, then on the due date he has to repay it. There may be an agreement between the banker and the customer by which a banker is saying, every month I will pay you some fixed amount. So all categories of repayments are included by the word otherwise. So the first otherwise is all comprehensive with regard to the repayment modalities of a banker. It can be either on demand or in installments or in once to one go after a fixed period. So that is the first otherwise. The second otherwise, the second otherwise is more interesting. It is withdrawable by check, draft and order or otherwise. Why they have added the word otherwise? Had they not added the word otherwise, this definition would have become invalid. Why? Today, banks have installed, after 1985, 1990, banks have installed thousands of ATMs and money is drawing from ATMs. Many people are now using internet banking. Now many people are using, again another set of people, youngsters have started using the mobile payment systems. And therefore, all these are not included here. If they have simply said withdrawable by check or draft and put a full stop, then the money could not be withdrawn from ATM. The money could not be withdrawn using a mobile payment system. So the framers of the law, in their abundance of wisdom, have used this otherwise, which includes payment through ATMs, payment through mobile payment, payment through any system that may come in future. We do not know. After 20 years, there may be another method, totally different method, through which the banker's money may be utilized. So this otherwise includes that also. Therein lies the beauty of this definition, which is a time-tested definition, which is a very beautiful definition, because it is an all-encompassing, simple, it's all-encompassing. In one aspect, it encompasses the entire gamut of banking. And the other aspect, if it is very simple, the second point is, it is a time-tested definition. It stands valid, it stood valid 1949, it stood valid for nearly 60 long years, and it is going to stand valid for I don't know how long future also. It is all encompassive and it's very simple, and it tells the essence of banking. Banking is nothing but accepting of deposit. As I told you in the first slide, that a banker is a bridge between depositor and borrower. So from the depositor, bank accepts deposits and then hands it over or lends to the borrowers. This is the primary function of a bank, and therefore banking is accepting deposits from the public for the purpose of investment or lending, repayable on demand or otherwise, and withdrawable by check, draft or order or otherwise. So it is a very beautiful definition. All of you, I suggest you read this definition carefully 2-3 times and try to imbibe the beauty and serenity of this definition. With that, we shall go to the next aspect of what is banking.